was an early morning ballroom, and the place just opened up, and the little man come in so fast that he started at his cups, and the broad served the whiskey. She was a big old friendly girl, and she tried to fight her empty nights by smiling at the world. She said, "Hey bub, it's been a while since you've been around. Where the hell you been hiding, and why you look so down?" But the little man sat there like he never heard a sound. What the waitress, she gave out a cough, and acted not the least put off. She spoke once again. She said, "I don't want to bother you, consider it's understood. 'Cause I know I'm not no beauty queen, but I sure can listen good." And the little man took his drink in his hand, and he raised it to his lips. He took a couple of sips, and he told the waitress this story. "I am the midnight watchman down in Miller's Tool and Die, and I watch the metal rust and I watch the time go by. A week ago at the diner I stopped in for a bite, and to see a lovely lady she sat two seats from my right. And Lord, 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 she was alright. Well, she was so damn beautiful, she'd warm a winter's frost. But she was long past lonely and well nigh into loss. Well, I'm not much of a mover or a pick-em-up easy guy, but I decided to glide on over and give her one good try. And Lord, 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 she was worth a try. Tongue-tied like a schoolboy, I stammered out some words, but it did not really matter much, 'cause I do not think she heard. She just looked clear on through me to a space back in my head, and it shamed me in the silence when quietly she said, 'If you want me to come with you, well, that's alright with me. 'Cause I know I'm going nowhere, and anywhere's a better place to be.'" Anywhere's a better place to be. So I drove her to my boarding house, and I took her up to my room. I went to turn on the only light to brighten up the gloom, but she said, "Please leave the light off, for I don't mind the dark." As her clothes all tumbled round her, I could hear my heart. The moonlight shone upon her as she laid back in my bed. It was the kind of scene I only had imagined in my head. I just could not believe it, to think that she was real. But as I tried to tell her, she said, "Shh, I know just how you feel. If you want to come here with me, well, that's alright with me. 'Cause I know I've been so lonely, Loving someone is a better place to be. Anywhere's a better place to be. Well, the morning comes so quickly, and I held her in my arms. But she slept like a baby, snug and safe from harm. I did not want to share her with the world or break the mood. So before we woke, I went out to get us both some food. When I came back with my paper bag, find out she was gone. She left a 6-word letter. It's time that I moved on. Well, the way took a ball rag and she wiped it across her eyes. And when she spoke, her voice came out as something like a sigh. She said, I wish that I was beautiful, or that you were halfway blind. And I wish I weren't so doggone fat. I wish that you were mine. And I wish you would come with me when I leave for home. 'Cause we both know all about emptiness and living all alone. Well, the little man looked at the empty glass in his hand, and he smiled a crooked grin. He said, I guess I'm out of gin, and I know we both have been so lonely. If you want me to come with you, well, that's all right with me, 'cause I know I'm going nowhere, and anywhere